Hello, hello. My name is Erin, and the song I'm going to play today is Wild Nights. One, because I'm an amateur guitar player, and this one's really easy. Not to say I won't make mistakes, I promise I will. But for now, I like to stick with basic, so here we are. Also, it's a song that reminds me of the first band I was in, Get Off My Lawn. Horrible band name, but really good band. And I knew it was important to honor Get Off My Lawn because they kind of launched me into this territory of really embracing that messy part of pursuing your joy, like the vulnerability and the risk-taking. They really created like an ongoing space for me to put that into action. So it's exciting for me to play a song that makes me think of that and represents that for me. For it to make sense, I would have to explain the story of how I got into that band. And it starts with me like almost 30 years old, still scared to pursue music in a like really meaningful way, which led me to Craigslist, of course. And Craigslist connected me with this guy who is trying to get this jazz trio off the ground. And I played with him for a few months. It didn't go anywhere, but it did create an opportunity for me to sing with another guy who was starting something really similar. So this guy initially was very excited to have me in the band, and I was excited to be in the band, and then they kicked me out after three practices. And I was devastated, like tears, choking on the couch. Like, it just restarted this story in my mind that I'm not good enough to pursue this thing that means so much to me and brings me so much joy. So it was tough. And that phrase, like, you gotta get back on the horse. I thought of that. I thought, I have to get back on the horse. And so in the midst of my tears, I open up my laptop and I go to Craigslist again thinking, I just have to get to an audition. That's it. Like, but if I don't get to an audition, I might never sing again. And I deserve to do that. So I look at Craigslist and there's an audition for a rock band. And I think that could be fun to channel like Pat Benatar for an hour on a Wednesday night. That sounds great. Let me do that. So I go to this audition and these guys are ridiculously talented. I had so much fun channeling my Pat Benatar and Grace Potter, Sheryl Crow, Melissa Etheridge, just had such a good time and left there on a total adrenaline high, knowing like, yeah, I gotta do this again. So the next day I meet with a friend of mine for margaritas. And while we're there, I get the email that says, you're in, we want you in the band. And I shared it with her and we're both excited. And I'm like, so how am I gonna tell them that I can't do this? And my friend Kendall looks at me, she's like, you just spent 30 minutes telling me how excited you are about this. Why would you not join this band? And I was like, well, they're gonna kick me out. I'm not a rock singer, I can't do it. And she got so serious, like the tough love mom face, and like emphatically puts her margarita down and her tone changes. And she says, Erin, if they kick you out, then that's their loss. But if you decline this opportunity, it is your loss. I thought, well, that's profound and true. So I replied and I said, yeah, I'll do it. And not only did they not kick me out, but I grew so much as a singer and I'll say musician. I still don't put myself in that category, but I just grew so much and my confidence blossomed and they did so much for me to keep pushing me out of my comfort zone. So the moral of that story and what this song and that band means to me is that you are enough, period. You also deserve to pursue anything that brings you joy. If you're not hurting anybody, then by pursuing joy, you're just creating this higher frequency and creating more positive energy in the world. And that just makes the world a better place. So I'm going to play Wild Nights imperfectly. I hope it brings you some joy. Yeah. Your hair, grab your coat and hat. Mistakes promised, mistakes delivered. That was fun for me. Hope it was fun for you.